Hello dear students, today we are going to continue in this part 2 with some terms. You know, we need to understand these terms for doing share capital questions like oversubscription of shares. What do we mean by this? Oversubscription means when we receive more application as compared to the shares issued in the market. That means if we have offered to general public, say for here 10,000 shares are issued in the market, but in response of it, public has given subscription for 15,000 shares. That means 5,000 share more are subscribed. So this situation is known as oversubscription of shares. Let us see about details of it ahead. Okay. Here, excess of the applications received, naturally we cannot keep with us. Our requirement is of 10,000. So, excess application which is received has to be rejected. So, under this matter, some applications are accepted in full and excess applications are rejected and amount received on them is completely refunded. Like 10,000, hum rakhenge, baki jitne excess hai, that is 5,000. 5,000 is surplus, that 5,000 amount will be immediately refunded while setting the amount received on the applications. Okay? Understand this very clearly. The surplus amount received on application, if no information is given in the question, that will be adjusted towards the allotment money and any excess is to be refunded. Okay, ye aapko kudhi, when we'll do practical, we will even understand about it. Okay. I'm taking this concept to a bit higher level. Sometimes company does pro-rata allotments also. Jab excess application milti hai, toh pro-rata allotment. No doubt, this time this concept is totally removed from your syllabus. Par hum log iska knowledge le lete hain. What does this mean? Under this, what happens? Whatever amount is or the applications are excess received, pro-rata allotment is done partially. Partial allotment is done to the investor. Puri ki puri rejection nahi hoti hai. Kuch accept hoti hai aur kuch reject hoti hai in case of pro-rata allotment. Okay? So in this case, rather rejecting all the excess here, the pro rata means the shares are accepted on partial basis. Means shares are not allotted to all applicants under this. Some portion of the share is given to them and some portion is rejected. So naturally we have some excess money on this received. In this case, this excess money is adjusted in further installments of allotment and call. So, that only is there. This type of adjustment is known as pro-rata allotment. We have practicals in your exercise, but this time they are just due to COVID, they have been excluded from the syllabus, not included. But concept ka knowledge hona zaruri hai. Aage badhenge. Here, what I mean to say is that excess money is retained by business and for adjustments to our allotment and call. In case of what? In case of pro-rata allotments. In this case, partial basis shares are issued. Har ek ko nahi deke, hum sabko thode thode shares diye jaate hain. To humko paise to application pe sabke mil gaye hote. To jo excess money hota hai, the excess money is retained by the business for the future use and adjusted. Okay, this type of questions we don't have now, right now. Okay, let us see, entry ke through samajhne ki koshish kare na, when excess applications are completely rejected. Just example liya tha na, we have issued 10,000. Okay, kitne issue kiye hain? 10,000. In iske response pe mila kitna hai? 15. So, 5,000 shares are to be rejected. Suppose, application is of 10 rupees, suppose. So, easy rehta, just for calculation. Now, milenge kitne? 15,000 pe 10 rupees milenge. 1 lakh 1.5. सो एंट्री अमाउंट मिलेगा, बैंक अकाउंट डेबिट टू शेयर एप्लीकेशन, बट सेकेंड एंट्री विल बी दैट अमाउंट विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड, द अमाउंट रिसीव्ड इन एप्लीकेशन. पहले पैसे मिले, अब क्या होगा, ट्रांसफर करेंगे एप्लीकेशन अमाउंट टू शेयर कैपिटल एंड एक्सेस अमाउंट विल बी इमीडिएटली रिफंडेड थ्रू बैंक. लेट अस सी सेकेंड एप्लीकेशन, सेकेंड एडजस्टमेंट ऑल्सो. ओके, नाउ बोथ एंट्रीज आर हियर. पहले पैसे मिले, बैंक अकाउंट डेबिट टू जो भी टाइप का शेयर है, इक्विटी है, प्रेफरेंस, उसका नाम लिखेंगे टू दिस शेयर एप्लीकेशन अकाउंट. ओके, नाउ वी नो 5000 एक्सेस है, तो 5000 इंटू 10 50 रिटर्न करने हैं. सी एक्सेस अमाउंट इज टू बी रिजेक्टेड हियर. एंट्री की तो बताइए, कैपिटल अकाउंट डेबिट टू शेयर, कैपिटल अकाउंट कितना 1 लाख, एंड टू बैंक, रिजेक्शन के लिए जितना पैसा है बैंक के थ्रू हम रिटर्न कर देंगे. सो दिस इज द एंट्री, कंप्लीट रिजेक्शन इज देयर, नो प्रोरेटा अलॉटमेंट वॉज डन. ओके, सो इन दिस वे एंट्री इज पास, अमाउंट रिसीव बैंक टू एप्लीकेशन, अमाउंट ट्रांसफर्ड एप्लीकेशन टू शेयर कैपिटल टू बैंक. लेट्स मूव ऑन. लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड इफ एक्सेस अमाउंट इज केप्ट फॉर फ्यूचर यूज इन केस ऑफ प्रोरेटा, तो एंट्री में किस तरह से चेंजेस आता है. ओके, नाउ इन दैट केस जितना अमाउंट आया, वी आर टेकिंग अनदर एग्जाम्पल, इफ 200 शेयर्स वन पर्टिकुलर पर्सन इज टेकन और 2 रुपीज पर शेयर इज द एप्लीकेशन, इन दैट केस व्हाट हैपेंस, तो उसे मिलेंगे कितनी. हमने अगर ऑफर किए 200, तो हमको 200 पे 2 रुपीज मिले. बैंक अकाउंट डेबिट टू शेयर एप्लीकेशन अकाउंट 400 रुपीज आर रिसीव. दिस वन इज वेरी सिंपल एंट्री एंड यू नो पैसे मिले हैं एप्लीकेशन के. लेट इज मूव ऑन. सी हाउ एक्सेस अमाउंट इज टू बी एडजस्टेड हियर, that only is to be understood. Here on transfer, the application amount with which is to be given to, see, share capital and then excess amount is to be transferred. How it is adjusted here? Application account, let us check. Application account debit to share capital account, to share allotment account and to call in advance. 2 रुपए उन्होंने क्लियरली एप्लीकेशन किए थे, तो 60 उसको शेयर्स अलॉट करने, 60 into 2, 60 into 3 उसका अलॉटमेंट आ गया. और जो एडवांस है, आई मीन टू से जो एक्चुअल अमाउंट है, सी द अमाउंट विच बिलोंग्स टू कैपिटल विल बी ट्रांसफर टू कैपिटल अकाउंट, द अलॉटमेंट अकाउंट विल गो टू दैट एंड द अमाउंट एडवांस विल बी ट्रांसफर टू अ स्पेशल अकाउंट नोन एज कॉल इन एडवांस अकाउंट. नो डाउट दिस टाइम दिस कंसेप्ट इज ऑल्सो eliminated due to COVID-19 reduction of syllabus. Knowledge only we have taken. Let's move on for next concept. Yeah, under subscription. Pehle over dekha means jyada. Naam se hi pata chalta hai. Under means kam. Under subscription of share means when less applications are received as compared to the share issued. Simply, हमने अगर 10,000 शेयर्स ऑफर किए हैं, उसके अगेंस्ट हमको पब्लिक सिर्फ 8,000 ले रही है, तो दिस सिचुएशन ऑफ कंपनी व्हेन कंपनी इज नॉट एबल टू गेट द शेयर सब्सक्राइब, देन ऑल शेयर्स आर नॉट सब्सक्राइब, दे इश्यू बट डोंट गेट इट सब्सक्राइब फ्रॉम द पब्लिक, देन सच सब्सक्रिप्शन इज अंडर सब्सक्रिप्शन. तो सम रूल्स अबाउट इट वी विल अंडरस्टैंड. लेट अस मूव. सी व्हाट एसईबीआई गिव्स अस गाइडेंस. SEBI says that it is compulsory that at least 90% of issued shares are subscribed. If issue is not subscribed up to 90%, that is minimum subscription, then company, this is known as minimum subscription, 90% amount. Now, then company is not allowed to allot any shares. Am I clear? Minimum 90% of the shares must be subscribed. If it goes below that, and then according to rules of SEBI, Security Exchange Board of India, we are not supposed to allot shares. All allotment money, all the money which is received with the application has to be refunded within the specified period. We need to return full money. Okay, so that is to be kept in mind. So, at least up to 90% the amount should be, must be subscribed. Let us move on. Yeah, if you ask me about treatment of under subscription, I will simply say, as per companies, company is not supposed only to give accept any subscription. So no transaction will be there. Hence, all entries are to be recorded as per shares applications only to shareholders. I mean to say that under subscription, then company has to go for reprocess. At least 90% must be subscribed. Okay, let's move on. Just for your knowledge, this topic is also slashed down, but we need to receive its knowledge. See, issue of shares other than cash. Generally, company issues share in the market to raise the capital directly. But sometimes, company even issues shares for purchase of building, plant, machinery. Sometimes in due of some services, shares are issued. So, issue of shares other than cash is one of the concepts which we will get some knowledge right now. See, on purchase of asset, simply direct entry karni ho to asset comes in or humko vendor. Asset account debit to vendor or seller account. Okay, let us move on. Then if share is issued for asset at par, then vendor account debit to share capital. Okay, but at premium, then vendor account debit to share capital to security premium. You will say, what is premium? Premium is the amount which is taken more. Par means 100 ka share, 100 pe. Last video mein kiya tha. Premium means more than the face value. 100 ka share 110 mein hai, to that is known as share issued at a premium. Practical karenge, is concept ko bahut acche se aage samjhenge. Okay? Premium to kya? Hum log to vendor ko discount pe bhi share de sakte hain. So in that case, if it is at premium, it is profit credited. But if it is as discount, discount is a loss. So discount will be debited against value. Vendor's account debit, discount account debit to share capital. Simple tarika hai yaad karne ka. Premium profit, either credit ho raha hai. Discount loss, debit hoga entry mein. Okay, knowledge of it is necessary for you. Now, let us check very important terms which we will use practically very on and often, like called up. Called up means an amount which is called by the company for the shareholder to be paid. It is the part of share capital called by the company to be paid by the shareholder. Okay, so called up is the first term we have done. Next, paid up. Again, jaisa naam bata raha hai, an amount which is received by a company from a shareholder. So this is an amount which shareholders pays into company on response to the call of the company. Company call karti hai, usko called up. Uske response mein jo paise pay karta hai shareholder, usko bolte hai paid up capital. It is a part of capital which is paid by the shareholder. Okay, so that's there. Next, third, call in arrears means an amount which is not received by the company in response of the call done by the company. Company ne call kiya, but investor ne time se nahi diya hai. So that amount which is not received from the shareholder in response of call is known as call in arrears. Okay, it is a part of amount called by company but not paid by the shareholders. Call in arrears. In advancement of it, if we say, if some amount is received more, that is known as call in advance. Means the amount which is received in advance from the shareholder. If the company has called, say, for only 4 rupees, but if investor pays 5, so 1 rupee more which investor is paid, such an amount which is received by the company before due date or call from an investor is known as, or it is to be known as, call in advance. Okay, so call in arrears, amount not received. Call in advance, amount received more. Okay, these accounts we will have to deal in with. Now here we have even seen one condition in last video, that shares can be issued at par, that is at face value. Jaise 100 rupees ka share 100 rupees mein offer kare, so that is issued at par. Even we have seen a lump sum amount can be taken, or even amount can be collected for the share in installments. Now, even this concept we need to have a brief idea before we go for practicals. That is issue of share at a premium. That means if when company issues share at the value more than the nominal value. Okay, उसकी nominal value से ज़्यादा, suppose 100 रुपए का share है, उसको 110 में launch करते हैं, तो 10 rupees the amount which is charged extra than the face value or nominal value is known as premium. Now, not only this much, you need to understand one more important certain rules about it. Extra amount received by the company is treated separately. Here, it must be credited to a separate account known as security premium account or security premium reserve account. Okay. In balance sheet also, it is shown under the separate, not under shareholders fund, but reserve and surpluses under the heading of reserves and surpluses. These are the basic rules or concepts we need to understand before we go for any practical. Here, we need to understand where it can be used. Only for knowledge purpose, the extra amount collected by company and by this, it restriction over use of it is there. Use to karenge, lekin kahan kahan kar sakte hai na, uska restriction hai. It can be used for fully paid bonus shares, writing of preliminary expenses, writing of expenses of issue of share or debenture like commission or discount paid, paying the premium, any premium at the time of redemption of share or debentures, even buying back own shares, this amount can be used. Which amount? Amount of security premium. Basic knowledge is required. Let us move on. Very important treatment practically karenge tab understand karenge, but right now conceptually also you must know how security premium amount or reserve amount is treated. It is treated separately, but then it is nothing but the amount to be adjusted with the allotment money or whichever call it is issued. It is assumed that allotment money includes the premium if nothing is mentioned in the question, but the stages are given in the question, at that particular stage only it will be credited against the capital. Jo capital ka paisa hai wo capital mein jayega aur premium ka paisa premium mein jayega jis stage pe bhi hoga. Okay, nothing is mentioned, then at allotment it is adjusted. If it is mentioned, then at that particular stage, whether it is application, allotment or call. Let us have a practical view of this in transaction. Nothing is mentioned, allotment, bank account debit to share application account debit to share capital and security premium reserve account. This amount which is excess received will be directly transferred to a special account known as security premium. Mila to hai bank to share application, transfer ke time pe share application to share capital and to security premium reserve account. Okay, if premiums amount is received with call, to jab demand karenge call ke liye, to call account debit to share capital to security premium, then amount is received bank to call. If it is done with this way, allotment stage, then also share allotment account debit to share capital to security premium. I mean to say, जिस स्टेज पे होगा उसी की कैपिटल के साथ एडजस्ट होता है, दैट यू नो टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो विद दिस बेसिक नॉलेज वी विल स्टार्ट अप विथ अवर प्रैक्टिकल्स. वी विल अंडरस्टैंड बेसिक एंट्रीज एंड स्टार्ट अप विद द प्रैक्टिकल पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. ओके, थैंक यू. लेट अस गो फॉर फर्दर वीडियोज. पार्ट 3 वी विल स्टार्ट अप विद द प्रैक्टिकल. थैंक यू एवरीवन.